Corey Haim stars in the teen comedy Dream Machine over on Sky Movies Plus. And here on Sky One, we visit the House of Games for review night in Games World. Stay with us.
To Sky One, about the small town of Rome, Wisconsin, its public and private passions.
You're quite a man, Officer Luckles.
Where the police department is kept extremely busy.
Neighbor discovered her halfway through the recycle.
You're telling me she committed suicide by climbing into her own dishwasher?
Expect the unexpected in Picket Fences, coming soon to Sky One.
What's happened to the orange Smarties? What tricks are they triggering with their extra orangey power? What can zap a tangy Terminator with 8 sonic orange sounds? Only Smarties have the answer. Orange Avengers should arm themselves with a Smartie Zapper before it's too late.
Alpine Strawberry. Strawberry with mulberry, with raspberry, with vanilla. Sainsbury's low-fat fruit yogurts, only 75p, the ones to pick.
Can you tell the difference between Surf and higher-priced liquids? Put it to the test on stubborn stains like ketchup, gravy, and butter. No liquid cleans better than Surf because it's got all the stain digesters of other liquids. Look, no difference at all. Except it costs you less. That's the Surf difference, and if you're not completely satisfied, we'll give you your money back. Surf. Tackle stains, cuts costs.
You don't have to be beautiful.
Excellent!
To turn me on.
Wow, did you see that?
I just need your body, baby.
Marvelous.
From dusk till dawn. You don't need experience.
Greetings, Islander.
To turn me out. You just leave it all up to me. I'll show you what it's all about.
Here's Johnny.
You don't have to be rich to be my girl. You don't have to be cool to rule my world. Ain't no particular sign I'm more compatible with. I just want your extra time and your...
Go ahead.
Cheers.
Hasta la vista, baby.
Big kiss.
You gotta not talk dirty, baby, if you wanna impress me. You can't be too flirty, mama. I know how to undress me. Let me be your fantasy, and maybe you could be mine.
Charlie, don't surf!
You just leave it all up to me.
Now's the time.
We can have a good time. You don't have to be rich to be my girl. You don't have to be cool to rule my world. Ain't no particular sign I'm more compatible with. I just want your extra time and your kid. Think I better dance now.
Rock and roll!
Let's rock!
Are you ready?
Hit it!
Yo!
Showtime!
Let the saliva flow!
These are just some of the films that you can see on Sky in July and August, including the British television premieres of Dead Again, Free Jack, Little Man Tate, Curly Sue, Deceived, Barton Fink, Blame It on the Bellboy, and Double Impact. So, stay tuned, or you'll be missing the kissing.
You're the one.
This is Sky One, a part of the British Sky Broadcasting Network.
Welcome to Games World. Tonight is review night, so please enter the House of Games.
Welcome once again to the House of Games, your guide to the best buys in the video game market.
Tonight we'll be giving you the lowdown on games such as Techno Clash on the Mega Drive and Blues Brothers on the SNES.
And hot from the Consumer Electronics Show in Chicago, I'll be previewing the best games that are about to hit these shores.
But in the meantime, let's get on with tonight's first game, which is Techno Clash on the Mega Drive. Evil monsters from our very own planet Earth threaten the inhabitants of the ancient and mystical kingdom of the Inner Realm. And with just the help of his two able-bodied bodyguards, Chaz and Farg, Prince Ronan has to save the population and cleanse the landscape. Using a top-down bird's-eye style view, you must guide the prince and his regal bouncers around the apocalyptic-like levels, solving puzzles and blasting whatever gets in your way. With this in mind, Ronan has an awesome arsenal of weapons to access, including lightning, fireballs, time bombs, and boomerangs. Although this interesting merger of fantasy and high technology looks more like a role-playing game than any other genre, there's no shortage of high-speed action.
Techno Clash is it's really a guns blazing shoot 'em up. It's very thinly disguised as an RPG. Its biggest bonus is probably the wide number of weapons that are available to you right from the start of the game. The sound effects are limited, and the graphics remind me a little bit of Team 17's Alien Breed. I can't help feeling I've seen it all before, except for the size of the game.
When you first start playing Techno Clash, you immediately think it's going to be another gauntlet game, but it's not. It's far more strategic than that, and you need to carefully learn the way that the enemies attack and which spells work best in which situation. The first level doesn't really represent the game as a whole, as it's a little bit dull, but once you get past that, things soon hot up and it soon becomes incredibly frantic. The bodyguard element is good, but he could be a little bit more intelligent, and on some occasions he wanders off to the side and you don't know exactly what he's doing.
The graphics were pretty good and the sound was good, but basically you just had to go around killing everybody that you saw.
A blasting 7.
I'd give this 6 out of 10, as it's not really anything new.
5 out of 10.
Well, Techno Clash would have been okay if the Mega Drive hadn't had so many other similar games on offer. Still, it scores a 5, a 6 and a 7 worth investigation. Now, with some latest news from the other side of the Atlantic, here's Jane.
Last week, we had a look at some of the hardware on display at the Chicago Consumer Electronics Show. Now it's time for a sneak preview of some of the red-hot games that were there. Most of them are going to be over here really soon.
A new game coming out for the Super Nintendo, and it'll be out this September. It's called Mario and Wario. It's a mouse-based game. It's a puzzle game where Wario has stuck a bucket on Mario's head. You've got to get Mario through 100 different stages, a total of 8 different worlds, and it should be a lot of fun for both children and adults.
Jurassic Park Sega CD, appearing on the Sega CD system. Incredibly huge, 600 megs worth of information. This game could never appear on a cartridge. It has real full motion video. It has 3D rendered graphics. It has real CD audio sound. It's going to be a great game and one of the best licenses Sega's ever had.
Kids, when they involve, when they play the game, when they see the game, they learn a lot about the game. This is very important. The people, they don't realize how is important for the kids. Because the kids, when they stay in the games, they stay out of the drugs, out of the street, they stay out of the bad scene. This is very important to realize.
It's Jungle Book from Virgin Games. Being developed for the Genesis, for the SNES, for the NES, the Game Boy, and the Game Gear. Releasing it in Europe around November of this year. It's been in development for about 6 months now. It's about 11 levels. Gameplay is platform style and features a lot of animation. There's some very cool stuff with Mowgli, and we have high hopes for it.
This is Acclaim's Mortal Kombat. It's available on Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis.